Imagine a world where manufacturing isn't confined to sprawling megafactories, but can be done on a smaller, sustainable, and local scale. From advancements in AI and robotics to breakthroughs in sustainable energy and healthcare innovations, we're here to provide you with the essential information you need to stay ahead. I'm Matt, and here's what you need to know about microfactories. Microfactories challenge the traditional manufacturing paradigm, where mass production and global supply chains dominate. Instead of relying on vast, specialized facilities to churn out products at high volumes, microfactories offer a more flexible, adaptable, and sustainable solution. They can be set up quickly, reconfigured easily, and scaled to meet local demands, all while maintaining high efficiency and low costs. The history of manufacturing is about mass production, about creating a line that can crank out one product at increasing volumes with greater and greater efficiency, which, of course, drives down costs. The result has been the creation of specialized megafactories supported by global networks. You might recognize this example of a modern supply chain. Megafactories are improving with robotics, artificial intelligence, and advanced network technology. It's really hard to compete with megafactories. But here's the interesting thing about these new technologies. While they can be used to make huge specialized megafactories even bigger, faster, and more efficient, they also make it practical to build and operate small factories, microfactories, that can build lots of different products on a mostly local level. Sort of like some of the prototyping lines you see today, only fast enough, smart enough, and efficient enough to be competitive. For the first time in a very long time, small, local production can match the efficiency of mass production. In microfactories, automated production lines can be fully flexible. They can be modular instead of linear. They can learn how to build different kinds of products. This opens the door for high-mix, low-volume production to be just as cost-effective as traditional, low-mix, mass production. Making low-volume production flexible also makes it practical, meaning factories don't have to be bigger to be more efficient, they can be smaller. This means they can also be less expensive, serve local needs, and rely on local supply. And microfactories won't just be smaller, they should be greener. Their agility will allow for responsive production, minimizing waste by making only what's needed. Local sourcing and shorter supply chains will further shrink the carbon footprint. That's why microfactories are poised to be a sustainable revolution within manufacturing. Microfactories won't replace traditional megafactories in the global market. They'll be complementary. The exciting part is the barriers to building a microfactory are so much lower than they are for building a megafactory. This should make it easier for new competitors to enter markets. Advanced tools will allow them to adapt to local needs, creating a more environmentally friendly and responsive manufacturing force alongside traditional megafactories. By the way, you've probably heard of Industry 4.0 and Industry 5.0. Industry 4.0 is mostly about pushing automation as far as it'll go. Industry 5.0 describes a manufacturing future where humans and smart machines work together. The idea is to combine human ingenuity with machine-based performance to make something greater. Microfactories are a great example of how Industry 5.0 visions can become reality. Thanks for watching this Need to Know episode about microfactories. From advancements in AI and robotics to breakthroughs in sustainable energy and healthcare innovations, we're here to provide you with the essential information you need to stay ahead. To learn more about microfactories, read the full article linked in the description below. You can also check out the rest of our technical library with all sorts of topics and articles. And to stay on top of our videos, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.